As I've established in previous episodes, I moved in 2020, and the property we bought came with this large 2,000 square foot shop, which I planned to build my dream toy museum in. Well, it took about 4 months to get the finishing work done on the shop and get it to the point where we could start moving items in and transform it into the toy museum we'll tour today. And I did a tour of the shop back in 2020, which I'll link on screen now and in the description box of this video. I'd encourage you to have a look at that episode to see the condition that this building was in before we started this project. Today, I want to give you a look at the completed project as a whole. I want to share how well everything fit together and show you how it was molded into this usable and livable space. I won't go into much detail on the collection itself, as I plan on future episodes breaking down those sections individually. So please leave your questions down in the comment section for me to address on those future episodes. I've designed this toy museum to be pretty compartmentalized and organized, as you'll see during today's walkthrough. I've also left room for expansion of certain collections. So now, without further ado, let's go inside and have a look around. When you enter the large museum area, the first thing you'll see are my cars. And I've introduced those on the show before, and I plan on doing individual episodes on each of these vehicles coming in 2022. So stay tuned for that and make sure you're subscribed to hear those stories. I continue the vehicle theme with a display of my die-cast cars, which as you can see are still housed in the Carney plastic display boxes that I unboxed back at the old place. Interesting fact, that's currently my number one viewed video on this channel. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it on screen now. And this is a good time to mention that the cases have held up fantastic through the move, and I've been very pleased with them. They've kept these cars safe, clean, dust-free, and accessible for over 3 years now, with no signs of aging or yellowing. In this area, there are also other cars of various shapes, makes, and sizes, including the very first Barbie car, which still has its original box. There are also various old magazines, many of which haven't been unwrapped from the plastic since the move. And collector car brochures like this 1988 Toyota MR2, which, as you all know, I have the full-size version in my collection. Now, speaking of magazines, the next section we come to is my comic book collection. I use Zapkapow's inventory software for maintaining what's in my collection. And one of these days, I'll give you all a closer look at that. Let me know down in the comment section if you have any specific questions for that episode. I haven't purchased any new comics in years, but I did leave room in this IKEA Calyx unit for expansion of my comic book collection. Next is the stage I built for all of my musical instruments. I started learning to play guitar in May of 2021, but I had a lot of these instruments already. And I know that that probably sounds pretty confusing, but it's a long story for another episode. I added the stage at the same time I decided to start playing and practicing regularly. And since that time, I've already added 3 new guitars to my collection, which, again, I'll detail the whole collection in a future episode. So questions in the comments section and subscribe to see that episode when it comes out. Now, speaking of subscribing, that seems like the perfect segue into my office space. This is where I do all of the editing for videos here on Cable TV, as well as Jedi TV. And this area in the corner stays pretty well climate controlled with the addition of the large mini split head situated on the wall. And it maintains the temperature in the entire shop pretty well, unless the outside temperature is extreme. The entire shop is heavily insulated, but it is a large and open space, and the closer you get to those garage doors, the more difficult it is to heat or cool. I plan on doing insulation on the garage doors this year and see what kind of difference that makes during the summer and winter months. This area is also where I play Nintendo games, watch movies, and unwind listening to music. I've got a nice turntable, a vintage collection of vinyl, and consoles dating back to the 80s. And the bulk of my toy collection starts here as well, with some of the original Fisher-Price toys I had as a kid. I played with these, my kids played with these, and now my grandkids play with them. Included with the Fisher-Price toys in this area are some great Playmobil sets, including the Mystery Machine, which you can see unboxed and reviewed by following the link on screen now. Moving on from there, I have two big IKEA PAX wardrobe closets. They're pretty much so exclusively used for costumes and props for costumes. I love to dress up for Halloween and other cosplay events. The wardrobes bookend the door which goes into my workshop, and we'll take a brief look in there at the end of this episode. But first, let's get a look at the main toy area. When I originally designed this area, I measured it out and laid it all out on paper and started to plan how many of the IKEA Billy bookshelves I could get into this space. I mapped it out and knew it was going to be a tight fit between the number of shelving units that I wanted and the actual wall space that I had. And as you can see, it was a perfect fit. Everything came together with no wasted space and plenty of room to not only house my current collection, but also allow for a little growth. And for a closer look at what's in my collection, I'd encourage you to take a look at the previous tour where all of these toys were packed into a 200 square foot space. I'll link that tour on screen for you now. Again, if you have any specific questions about the collection after watching this episode and the previous tour, please leave them in the comment section of today's episode. During the time I was building out this area, IKEA was closed due to the pandemic, so everything you see here was bought on the used market, like OfferUp or Marketplace. And that includes the Kallax units for my comics, records, toys, and the desk that's attached to them. All of this space was furnished that way. And the stage was built out of materials from the wall that we tore down inside the shop. So everything was done both economically and environmentally friendly. Although we did have to purchase new pegboard for my Nerf wall, which already needs to be expanded, but I left room to do that. It's just a matter of buying more material and painting the new pegboards to match the others. In its current configuration, the wall is 8 feet tall and 16 feet long and home to over 120 blasters. I do take my fun seriously. So, as you can see, this went from a big old dirty canvas of metal with a randomly placed wall and ceiling into this. My vision was for a big open space with high ceiling and sheetrocked walls all the way up to the windows so I could still get some natural light flowing in. And with time and with patience, we got it done. If you like it, give me a thumbs up on this video. If you want to see more, subscribe to Kbell TV. And before I show you out, I want to give you a look inside the smaller section through this door. This is a 400 square foot shop area that, if you've watched Jedi TV, you've already seen details about it. This is my workshop and storage area, climate controlled by a smaller mini split, which is definitely more than adequate for this size space. Even if I can't always maintain the temperature in the large museum space, this room stays very comfortable. And that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe because, you know, YouTube. This is Kbell TV. Until the next episode, have fun and play.